Alright guys, so let's have a revision of the things that we have done so far. I'll start right from the scratch. Wherever you have issues, please let me know. I would go slowly. I'm sure everybody would be able to recall the concepts. So we started with the non-action sentences, with the be forms and have forms. Okay, we just took out these forms, the present forms, past forms, and for future. We have is, am, are, was, were, and will be. Right? We can use these be forms with adjectives, the words like good or bad, or nouns, means names. The sentences that we are going to get, they will be actionless sentences. For example, he is Ankit. This is a noun, and he is happy. This is an adjective. वह अंकित है और वो खुश है. Right? Similarly for the past tense, we are going to say he was Ankit and he was happy. For future, we need to say वो अंकित होगा. That means he will be Ankit. वो खुश होगा. He will be happy. Right? So these are the forms that we had in the beginning. Is, am, are, was, were, will be. These basic forms will be used multiple times. In this case, is your main verb because there is no other verb in the sentence. So is a main verb. As a main verb, its meaning is equal to. Its meaning is hai or hona. Right? Similarly, was is a main verb, and out of will be is your main verb, and will is your helping verb. The last verb of the sentence is the main verb. There is no other verb. So this is the main. The same set of verbs can be used to make continuous sentences with ing main verb. They will work as helping verbs. So if you have main verb ing, they will become helping verbs. The sentence will be present continuous, past continuous, future continuous, means continuous tense will be there. Alright?
Yes.
For example, he is Ankit, he is happy because he is working in IBM.
Yes.
So the same set of rule is there. He is, he is, he is. After he is, you have a noun, you have an adjective, and you have a main verb, ing form. Alright. Similarly, let's make sentence for this will be. He will be Ankit. He will be happy because
he will be
working in, let's say, IBM. So if somebody says ये will be को कैसे कैसे use कर सकते हैं तो एटलीस्ट ये थ्री केसेस तो आई गए आपके सामने. आप will be के साथ कह सकते हैं ऐसा होगा. इक्वल टू वाला सेंस है, एडजेक्टिव और नाउन के साथ आ जाएगा. एंड विद दिस द मीनिंग विल बी हो रहा होगा. दैट्स कंटिन्यूअस सेंटेंस. ऑलराइट. ओके, लेट्स गो अहेड. द सेम सेट ऑफ रूल्स दैट वी हैव विद अस, द सेम सेट ऑफ रूल्स दैट वी हैव विद अस कैन बी यूज्ड अगेन to make passive voice sentences. Since we have already seen those rules, so we can quickly have an identification from here. You can use the same helping verbs with main verb third form.
Yes.
The moment you do this, if you see any be form plus third form, it will be a passive voice sentence. And this structure, is, am, are, was, were, will be plus third form, will be indefinite tense. This is not continuous. Continuous means ing must be there.
Yes.
There is no ing. Okay. For example, he is selected means उसे select किया जाता है by the company. He was selected, उसे select किया गया था. And he will be selected, उसे select किया जाएगा by the company. सब passive voice हैं. उल्टे. Are you comfortable till this point? The same verbs can again be used along with being plus third form. This is also passive voice because we have be form plus third form. They are all going to
yes.
be helping verbs now. So the sentence is going to be continuous in this case because being represents an ing form. This is passive voice. Indefinite and continuous. Right? For example, he is being awarded. Usko award diya ja raha hai by the company. Right? Past would be he was being awarded. Future is going to be he will be being awarded. Okay? So you can make these kind of sentences using is, am, or was, were, and will be, and that's it. There is no other rule with these forms. Itna hi rule hai aise. So have a look upon this, and we'll resume in 2 minutes. All right. So I'm just writing those sentences here. That will be the end of today's class. We just had a discussion on be forms. So this is your homework to fix these sentences at least. We have active on this side, passive on this side. Sentence number one is, they invite us. इसका हिंदी भी फिक्स होना चाहिए. वे हमें बुलाते हैं. The passive voice is, we are invited by them. हमें बुलाया जाता है उनके द्वारा. राइट, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड. इज एम आर प्लस थर्ड फॉर्म मीन्स कुछ किया जाता है. दिस एंडिंग इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके, गड़बड़ यही होगा. इज एम आर प्लस थर्ड फॉर्म को फिक्स करोगे, ये इंडेफिनेट है तभी मीनिंग फिक्स होगा, अदरवाइज गड़बड़ करते रहोगे. सेकेंड वन इज पास्ट इंडेफिनेट. उन्होंने हमें बुलाया था. दे इन्वाइटेड us. This is one time activity. उन्होंने हमें बुलाया था. They invited us. What will be its passive voice?
We were invited by them.
हमें बुलाया गया था. I'm not saying उनके द्वारा, वो बाई डिफॉल्ट मीनिंग में आ जाएगा. हमें बुलाया गया था. एंड द थर्ड वन इज हम बुलाएंगे, और यू सपोज वे बुलाएंगे. दे विल इनवाइट अस. वे हमें बुलाएंगे. व्हाट विल बी द पैसिव वॉइस?
वी
विल बी इनवाइटेड बाय देम. हमें बुलाया जाएगा उनके द्वारा. People generally don't have confusion in continuous and perfect tense in active and passive, but indefinite creates confusion. Indefinite पे problem आता है. So fix these six sentences. इसको इतना strongly fix करके आना कि next time मैं तुमसे कोई भी हिंदी पूछूंगा इन six में से तुम correct convert करोगे उनको. बहुत strongly fix करना इसको. प्रॉब्लम ये आएगा, आप बोलेंगे ये वाला हमें बुलाया जाता है, गलती से इधर वाला ट्रांसलेशन कर देंगे. डोंट डू दैट. फिक्स रखो ये वाला सेंटेंस, इसका पैसिव वॉइस ये वाला. कंटिन्यूस नहीं है, इंडेफिनेट है. कंटिन्यूस ईजी होता है, उसमें आईएनजी दिखता है. एक्टिव में तो डायरेक्टली मेन वर्ब में दिखता है, पैसिव में बीइंग में दिखता है, तो कनेक्शन हो जाता है माइंड में. इट्स नॉट दैट टफ. परफेक्ट बहुत आसान है, उसमें हैज हैव दिख रहे हैं सब जगह. इंडेफिनेट में प्रॉब्लम है. So guys, that's it for today's class. We can use be forms in these ways. Number one, for non-action, we can use for adjectives and nouns. Number two, with ing, we can make continuous sentences. For passive voice, we have two types of sentences. We can use them with third forms. We'll get indefinite. This example, we can use with being plus third form. We'll get continuous. That's easy. Right? So that's it for the class. We'll meet again. And we're going to have quick revision of have forms and passive voice and conditional sentences tomorrow. So we'll complete the revision in these two sessions and then we'll continue right after. Right? I'll say 1, 2, 3, we'll clap and shout. Everybody, 1, 2, 3.